JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for November the 26th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, head of research here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded higher against the majority of the other major currencies on Thursday during the Asian session Friday. It gained versus the Aussie, the Kiwi, the Canadian dollar, and the British pound in that order, while it lost ground versus the yen, the Swiss franc, and the euro. The picture in the FX sphere clearly points to market sentiment deteriorating at some point during the day or today in Asia. Indeed, turning our gaze to the equity world, we see that most European indices traded in the green, but today in Asia, investors abandoned stocks, with the four indices under our radar falling on average 1.78% each. Wall Street stayed closed in celebration of the Thanksgiving Day, but the futures market points to a decent negative gap at today's opening. At this point, it is worth mentioning that Wall Street will close early today. Now, yesterday, we noted that European shares may stay under pressure for a while more, and we stick to that view. We believe that the surging, that the increasing COVID cases and the new measures around the bloc will keep investors concerned over the future performance of the euro area economy. In our view, yesterday's rebound was just a short covering bounce, with news later in the day pointing to the detection of a new and possibly vaccine-resistant variant. We see the case for another slide, perhaps as early as today. After all, Asian markets suffered their sharpest drop in 2 months overnight due to those news. The only market for which we will alter our view for now is the US stock market. Remember that despite the increasing expectations over a potential Fed hike mid next year, we have been saying that Wall Street could climb towards new highs if economic data continue to suggest that the US economy is performing better than other major economies. However, the announcement of a possibly vaccine-resistant coronavirus mutation could spark fears there as well and result in a decent correction lower. As for the currencies, we stick to our guns that the US dollar will perform very well. But now, with investors seeking shelter to any safe haven asset, we would expect the yen and the franc to benefit as well. At the same time, the risk-linked currencies, Aussie, Kiwi, Loonie, and even the British pound could stay under some selling interest. We believe that monetary policy divergences will take the back seat for now, while the strategy of each central bank could even be altered in the foreseeable future if the COVID situation worsens. Now, as for today's events, the holiday shopping season officially starts with Black Friday sales around the globe. Although we will not get any instant numbers over how strong consumer spending was, we will closely watch the upcoming retail sales data. We don't have any top-tier data releases on today's agenda, but we will get to hear from ECB President Lagarde as well as by ECB members Panetta and Schnabel. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 8 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, a greater weekend, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again next week.
JFT, just fair and direct.